In the parable of the talents, a man traveling to a far country gives talents, that's an amount of money, something weighed out, to his servants. Matthew 25:15 says, "And unto one he gave 5 talents, to another 2, and to another 1, to every man according to his several ability, and straightway took his journey." Now analyze that just a little bit, and you'll see that in God's eyes, we don't receive exactly the same talents or the same amount as everyone else. Think about this. Someone sings like an angel, you do not. Someone is wealthy, maybe you're not. Someone is athletic or artistic, and you are not. Evidently, all of that is okay in the sight of God. We're not all the same, and that's because God didn't make us all the same, and He didn't give us all the same gifts. Don't worry about what you don't have. Unless it's something you can develop, you've got what God gave you. Now, can you imagine how liberating this is? Instead of mourning that you don't have the same eye for decorating as your friend, or you're not as musically inclined as the person who sits beside you in class, you can instead focus on what you've been given by God and on using that for Him. Can you imagine Van Gogh pouting about not being a great singer, or Beethoven complaining to God because he couldn't paint? It seems God would rather you celebrate your abilities and talents and not spend a moment worrying that they're not the same as what someone else has. You'll notice that in the parable, each person has what God gave them. So if you're tall, short, fast, slow, smart, super smart, a singer, a painter, a banjo player, a leader, a follower, take the same kind of joy in you that God takes in you. You be you. Focus on what God has given you and not on what He hasn't. I'm John Bradshaw for It Is Written. Let's live today by every word.